Health research authority approvals. The vision is to make it easier to undertake health research in the NHS in England and to simplify the process of approval for researchers, reducing the time and cost of setting up studies. The HRA approval process has been implemented in 6 cohorts. Cohorts 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 are now live. The only studies which will not yet go through HRA are those which are single site, site-sponsored studies and those which are solely for educational purposes. The HRA setup and process is outlined here. The process involves preparation of key documents, statement activities and scheduling of events, which are submitted to the HRA via IRAS. The HRA reviews the application and confirms if the application is valid. If further clarification is required, the HRA will issue an initial assessment letter. Once HRA assessment, including ethics review, is complete, the sponsor will be notified. The sponsor will send a local package to sites in order for the site to assess, arrange and confirm capacity. How to apply? In IRAS, select the option for HRA approval. There will be no separate R&D and rec forms. Prepare supporting documentation, for example, statement of activities and schedule of events for non-commercial and other study documentation. Uploading all the files to the relevant rows on the project documentation tab. Contact Central Booking Service prior to submitting IRAS. Submit the IRAS form for approval. At the moment, the IRAS form will have R&D and rec tick for question 4. If this is the case, you should untick these and tick HRA approval. You can see that the document checklist is now called Project Documentation, and there is still the function to create an SSI form. However, this should not be used. Statement of Activity and Schedule of Events. The Statement of Activity and Schedule of Events are for non-commercial trials only and can be downloaded from the HRA website. The sponsor and the study team should complete these and attach to the Project Documentation section on IRAS. The documents can be downloaded via this link. As part of the HRA review, an initial assessment is performed to confirm, is the study eligible? If the IRAS form is completed correctly, a validation letter is issued. The HRA assessment will assess for compliance and other related matters and liaise with the sponsor of nominated individuals. The conclusion, once both HRA assessment and rec review, where required, are complete, a notification of the outcome, the HRA approval, or not approved, in the form of a letter will be issued to the sponsor. A study cannot commence in the NHS in England until HRA approval has been issued. Local submission. At NUH, we'll be informed by the sponsor or the HRA that we have been selected as a site. Individuals will not need to submit documents via email. It is the sponsor's responsibility to provide these to the sites. If HRA approval is pending, the assess, arrange, confirm process can begin. If the study is already open and NUH are joining at a later date, the assess, arrange, confirm process will begin immediately. For studies where HRA have stated that confirmation of capacity is not required, NUH will look at the documentation and what the study involves to ensure there is no burden to staff or patients. The assess, arrange, confirm process is an extended feasibility to ensure that we have the capacity and capability to deliver the study at NUH. We look at study milestones such as recruitment targets, start and end dates, follow-up burden and regulatory approvals, whether all those involved have capacity to carry out the research and capability, and do we see the patients at NUH. The research project managers at NUH R&I will complete a study action plan document and capacity and capability is confirmed once this is signed off. What will change? Feasibility meetings will become a discussion of capacity at NUH. The statement of activity acts as an agreement where contract, NACA and CTA are not in place. No local governance review will take place. There will be no SSI form. A schedule of events will be provided for non-commercial trials. CSP will be decommissioned on the 31st of March 2016. What will not change? Costing will still need to be completed by the reviewer and finance approval obtained. Studies will still be performance managed. RNI and CRN involvement in study setup with a single point of contact through setup. IRAS will remain the primary tool for research applications for both commercial and non-commercial studies. Amendments, historic studies. When CSP is switched off, amendments will go through the HRA. This applies to all amendments for all studies, adopted and non-adopted. Addition of new sites. This will go through HRA via a light touch assessment. Send email to hra.approval@nhs.net with study documentation. For non-commercial, schedule of events and statement of activities should also be completed. Amendments and record approval. Those requiring approval continue to submit to the REC that initially reviewed the study, and info will be shared with HRA internally. Non-substantial amendments, those not requiring REC, submit to hra.amendments@nhs.net. Categorisation. HRA assessment staff will categorise as A, B or C and inform the applicant of the categorisation. This will be completed within 5 working days. A or B requires consideration by site. This can be implemented within 35 calendar days after the sponsor provides information unless concerns or objections are raised. C does not require consideration by site, so it can be implemented immediately. This flowchart illustrates the amendment process. In conclusion, there will be no SSI form. NUH will assess the capacity and capability of a study through the Assess, Arrange, Confirm process. CSP will be decommissioned on the 29th of March 2016. From this date, no further studies can be reviewed using the old system. For further information, please visit the HRA website or contact a local member of RNI.